Hi there, Jamie here today at Teachers Tech. Hope you're having a great day today. Today I want to show you how you can combine cells in Microsoft Excel. So what I mean is you could have whether it be numbers or text and combine them into one. So here's a little example of what I want to show you. Let's say I have a name and then I have a number. I can combine it to make it into this, so I can even add more. And then I can take this and copy it down just like that. So these are some of the tips of what I want to show you today on how to combine cells, text and numbers in Microsoft Excel. So for this lesson, we're not going to be using the concat or concatenate function. We're going to be using the ampersand to combine this cell over here with the number in this cell. So how we do this is we're going to start with our equation sign here, so our equal sign. And we're going to just select the first cell, and then we're going to use the ampersand sign, which is above the 7, shift 7. And now we click on our next cell, and I'm just going to hit enter. So as you can see, it's not quite exactly what I showed you in the intro. We need to do a few more things to it. So the first thing that we could do is give a space in between the R and the 3 here. So we can do this by going back up to the formula bar up here. So I'm just going to go ahead and select here, and I'm going to type in just the quotation marks here. And I'm going to put a space. So I just hit space bar, put another quotation mark. And now I need to add another ampersand sign. And I'm going to hit enter. So by doing that, now if I click on it, this space between the quotation marks acts as the space here. So what I'll, if I wanted a dollar sign on this to where it says the 350,000, I could go up here and I'm going to place it right here. So I have a space, but then I'm going to do my dollar sign, hit enter, and now I have a dollar sign right there. I'm going to come back and show you how we can format this number in a bit here, but I'm just going to continue on to show you that we can add an ampersand sign at the end too. So if I wanted to add that per episode, I just can go up to the top here, and this is where I can add another ampersand sign. And use, when you're typing, you need to use your quotation mark. So I'm going to say per episode, but I want a space. So I'm going to add a space first, and I'm going to say per episode, just like this. And I'm going to go quotation mark, and I'm going to hit enter. So now I have Winona Ryder $350,000 per episode just by using the ampersand sign and using the quotation marks to put spaces. Now there's something else I want to do. I could copy this all the way down just by double clicking and filling in, but I'm going to go back one step because I want to add formatting now. So this is a cool part of this because I want to add a formatting to this 350,000 where I have the comma in the correct spot and I'm going to have the dollar sign. So I'm going to actually remove the dollar sign from here because I'm going to use formatting for this. And what I'm going to have is we are going to use a function too. But before I go grab, put the function in, I'm going to grab some formatting. And to do this, you can right click anywhere in here. So I'm just going to right click and I'm going to go to format cells. You can see it right here. And I'll drag this up and where you need to go to custom. You can see all the things in here. We're going to actually copy formatting out of here. And so in the case of the number here that I want in it, it's going to be, it's going to have a dollar sign. I want it to be formatted and I want it to have comma. So if I look at this here, this is, you can see there's going to be negative, positive, how it's going to be formatting. I could take the whole thing and move it over. I could just take a chunk. So what I'm going to do is just highlight what I need here. And I'm going to just go Control C for copy. So I'm going to have this. I'm going to hit OK now. And a shortcut for this, if I go back to it, if I just hit Control 1, that's the shortcut that will get you there in a hurry too. So two ways to do that. Now, if I go back to this cell, I need to add the text function. And where I'm going to add it is before the B2. So B2 is the number. And I'm just going to start by typing text. And you can see the functions come up. And I'm going to just select text. It adds the bracket for me. And on this side of the B2, I need to add a comma. If you follow along, you can see where it says comma next. And I need to add a quotation mark. So I'm going to be pasting in that information that I copied from the formatting. So I'm going to go Control V. And now I'm going to go and do another quotation mark to end it, and I need to close my bracket. So when I close my bracket, I'm just going to go ahead and hit enter. And you can see now this is formatted with a comma to separate the thousands, and it has the dollar sign in there. So at this point, I can copy this all the way down, and it copies all the way down correctly with the formatting in here also. But we're not done yet here. I want to show you a couple other things that you can do with formatting numbers and copying text and numbers to get combining them. So what I want to show you now is how you can add text and have it not recognized. So what I mean by this is, let's say, so I have a formula, simple formula here. Here's my total of everybody here, 2.6 million of all of these. And then I have 9 episodes and I just divided it to get so much per episode. But if I was gonna go to here and go in this cell, and if I started typing episodes in here, so that's spelled incorrectly. So if I just type episodes, click off, it doesn't recognize it because it becomes text. You can see how it's aligning. There's having some issue in here, but you can actually add text here. So if I look at this, you can see what's typed up here, but I'm gonna go and actually format it so I can have words in it. So if I go back to this number 9 here, and I'm gonna use Control-1, the shortcut, go to custom, and this time, so it's just gonna be, I'm gonna use the 0, but I can actually add my own custom text formatting here. And so what I'm gonna do is add a quotation mark here. I'm gonna add a space and I'm gonna type episodes like this. And then I'm gonna end my quotation marks. So if I hit okay now, it says 9 episodes and it didn't wreck the formula. So if I look up in the formula bar up top, it still says 9. So I'll do that one more time. If I click on this one where the amount is, this is already formatted with the dollar sign. I'm gonna go Control-1. And I'm gonna go to custom, and maybe I just want the word total. So I can see there, if I go up and just pick a simple one here, you can go up and see all the different ones that you can pick. But if I was just picking this, and I'm gonna pick total, I can use my quotation mark, and I write total, and I'm gonna give a space, an end quotation mark, and now I have total, the $2.6 million, and nothing. If I look up at the sum, it's still there. The text isn't there, it's being recognized as a number. So that's a way that you can add text to a cell that doesn't get recognized as a number. And with any of these cells that you just formatted, just go back, I'm gonna use Control-1 again, check out the custom and notice that it's in here. So this is a format that's created. And if you didn't want it, you could delete it and you can see how it goes back to normal like that. So I just want to show you one last thing here, quick thing to end this video here today. I want to show you how you can copy your format from a different cell over to that text function. So you can see in this case, I've combined, if you look at the formula bar, it's the same thing that I showed you before, but it's coming out as 0.85. So I could, if I wanted to make sure I got the same as this, what I could do, if I click in this and then use my Control-1 or go to format cell, and then notice that it's at 85%, shows me the sample. If I go to custom, it carries over that percent. So what I need to do is highlight what I need to copy. So I'm just gonna go Control C, go back over to this one, go in front of the B2, and I'm gonna go and put my text function in like I showed you before. And at this point, I need my comma. So I need my quotation mark. I need to paste in that 0%, what I showed you before. I need to end my quotation mark just like that and end my bracket and hit return or enter. And you can see that now it's 85% and it copied the format from there. So I just want to show you that one last tip about when we're putting the formats into that text function. So I hope you like this way of combining cells here. Let me know what you think, if it's working for you down below in the comments. Thanks for watching this time on Teachers Tech. I'll see you next time with more tech tips and tutorials.